Hi, welcome to AirTech Solutions. This is Sheshanan. Now I am explaining data transfer instruction set from 8051 microcontroller. So most of you deal with academic things with assembly language from microcontrollers. So now I am explaining microcontroller data transfer instruction set among the complete instruction set. So which is divided into five parts: data transfer, arithmetic, logical, call and jump instructions, and Boolean instruction set. The first instruction set I am talking about data transfer now. So this is your complete data transfer instruction set with possible syntaxes. So now the instructions are very clear and you need to understand the description and this number of bytes which decides how many ROM memory locations it occupies for each instruction. There is cycles column is which is machine cycles. So your assembly language is always the combination of mnemonics followed by operands. As mnemonics, here most of the things are data transfer from one storage unit to other storage unit. It may be combination of registers, address with registers, constant value with registers, and address to address. So here move A,RR, which means from any general purpose register we are trying to use in a program. So there are 8 general purpose registers from R0 to R7 provided by 8051 CPU. And move A,ADD, which means any RAM address location which is data RAM from 00H to 7FH. Any address you can directly use it. Move A,@RP, which means from pointer register indirectly you can access RAM memory by using this pointer concept. So the indirect memory location you can access through this RP registers as R0 and R1. You have to use only R0 and R1 registers as pointers, no chance to use other registers. Move A,#N, which means 1 byte value you can directly assign with accumulator. And from accumulator to general purpose registers R0 to R7, which is RR, means you can use any general purpose register. And you can follow this description, the destination, where it is going to save, from where to where. And constant value I can directly assign with register. And accumulator value to address location, general purpose register value to address location, address to address, indirect address to address location, constant value into RAM memory location, accumulator value to pointer register, address to pointer register, constant value into pointer register, move DPTR, which means data pointer with 2 ends, which means 2 bytes value, which is 16 bit. Move CA,@A+DPTR. This instruction supports to indirect access of ROM memory using DPTR as pointer. So here C stands for code memory. I'll explain you this instruction with example. Move CA,@A+PC, which means program counter, and program counter which allows to store the next address which is going to execute. So whatever the content which is maintained by the next incoming address location execution, that value which is transferred to accumulator. And move X instruction deals with external memories, and external memory, again you have to use this pointer concept. If the address is 16 bit, use DPTR as pointer. If address is 8 bit, you can use RP as pointer. From external location to accumulator, from external RAM location to accumulator, and accumulator to external RAM location, accumulator to external ROM location. Push and pop instructions works with stack memory. So there is a stack pointer which is present in RAM memory. the stack pointer, the default address is 07, and push operation, which allows to save the data into stack initial address. Stack pointer default rolling address is 07. Whenever you are using push operation, stack pointer address increments by 1. For each push operation, one address will increment automatically. And push followed by source address. In the case of stack memory, destination is already fixed, which is the address of stack. And pop instruction followed by destination address. Here source is fixed. Source is stack. And in the case of push operation, destination is fixed. You have to mention your source address. And XCH, which means exchange operation between A and register, A with address, A with pointer register. And this mission cycles, how many cycles it is taking to execute. And your mission cycle has three stages: fetch, decode, and execute. So this instruction set talks about only data transfer operation between three storage units. So now RR means R0 to R7 registers, RP means pointer registers, only R0 and R1. ADD means RAM addresses you can use for your data transfer operations from 00H to 7FH. And hashing, which is 1 byte value. Now 8051 supports some list of CPU registers, which are A, B, R0, R1, R2 up to R7, and whereas DPTR for data storage. And the other storage section is RAM memory from 00H to 7FH. The another storage unit, which is ROM. So here three storage units, between these three storage units you can do your data transfer operations. So as per syntaxes, so between registers, between memory locations, from register to memory locations, from ROM memory to registers. Now I'll take one example: move the values of A and B registers into 10H and 20H RAM memory locations. So this is my simple code. Move A comma #25H. The first value I'm keeping into accumulator, and second constant value I'm trying to keep it in B register. Move 10H comma A, which means from accumulator to 10H address location. So I'll compile this program by using this Keil Microvision IDE. So you can cross check all your outputs from assembly language or any other embedded C language also. So but for that you need to create your, you have to follow these steps: create new project and select new project, and just remember this destination where you are trying to save your program. Now I selected D drive and created assembly folder. Now I am giving this file name registers to RAM. So most of you giving your different project names, but don't give that. If you are giving problem related names, it is easy to follow. Now I am giving this project name as register to RAM and click on save. And here this is your target window. Here you need to choose which microcontroller you are going to work. So Keil Microvision IDE support for all different manufacturers. From this list you need to choose one controller from one specific manufacturer as per your availability. Now I am selecting manufacturer name Atmel. Once you click on this plus mark, it will show the list of devices from this manufacturer. Now select your device, which is AT89C51. Select your device and click on OK. This is your startup code warning. If you click S, so There is no problem by clicking yes or no. Wait, what is startup code here, which maintains all the default values of registers and memory locations? Now I'm going with option no. Up to now, you given project name and you selected your target device for which microcontroller you are trying to write programs. Now you need to open editor window. Further, go file option, click on new. So this is your text editor. Here you need to write your program. Now I'm writing my sample code, which is to test my output with registers and RAM memory locations. So 10H memory location is I'm saving with accumulator value, and 20H memory location I filled with B register value. So after writing program in text editor window, you need to save this program. Further, go file tab and choose option save. So you need to give file name again, but your extension should be .asm here. Register to RAM. So any file name you can give. So no need to match your project name and program name. You can give different names also, but the extension is required for program, which is .asm, because I approached assembly language. Now click on save. If you want to go for good text, you can go with configuration option, colors and fonts. So this is my program. Now you need to compile this program by adding with this target. Just click on this target one option and click the plus mark. You will get source group one, which source file you are trying to compile with respect to target. Further, select your option, add files to source group one. But it will show you default source file is C source files. But now I written my program in assembly language. So you need to change it to ASM source file and select your file and click on add. Once the file is added, you'll get plus mark here. And after adding your source code into this target device, go with project tab and choose the option build a target. Now it will show errors and warnings present in the program. If you do any mistake, means not writing comma between operands, not giving space between numerics and operands, so then it will show you error. For every change of thing, you need to use the save button and build button. These are the shortcut buttons. Now I am entering into this debug tab to cross check my output. So this disassembly window show you what are the equivalent opcodes of this each instruction and how many locations it is occupying. The initial address is 000 of ROM memory, so it is taking two locations. Move A comma has 25 and move B comma 65 is also taking two locations, and move 10H comma A, it is taking two locations like this. Each instruction is taking two instructions as per in bytes from the instruction table. Now, if you are trying to compile this program line by line, use function key F11 from keyboard. Now, I got the value 25 into A. If I am pressing again F11, then the second line is executed, B value I received into B register. But where to find my memory locations? To watch your memory operations, go view tab and choose option memory window. Thank you. So view tab and choose option memory window. Now type your address. If you are looking to test your RAM, use D. If you are trying to check ROM memory, use letter C. Now I am checking RAM memory with the address 10H. And by default, all these values are zeros. If you execute this line by pressing F11 from keyboard, I receive 25 into this 10H location. Then what about 20H? Just change, modify your address, type it, hit the enter. Now zero value, but if this line is executes, then I receive 65. Then you can cross check what is the value with 10H, 25. And what is the value with 20H, which is 65. So this program, you can cross check your outputs just writing with a simple logics. After checking your output, again go for debug tab and stop the debug session. And I'm trying to check one more program, which is move the values of R0 and R1 registers values into stack memory. So now, I don't want to create new project. If you are trying to remove this program, and whatever the new program you are trying to write, go File tab and use option New. The second program, R0 and 1, R1 values into stack. But you know that as per RAM memory organization, registers occupies bank 0 initial address, which means indirectly, which is uses 00H RAM location and 01H RAM location. So now I am using simply push operation. Push follows only address as operands, which means the value is moving from 00H to 08H, because stack pointer default holding address is 07. Whenever you are using push operation, it increments one address. So 00 means what indirectly? Your R0 register. If I am writing push 01H, then from where to where? From R1 register to 09. Even I'll show you this program output. Just remove this previous program and first of all save this text file again by going file option and save it. So now this is stack, but always give the extension .asm for any assembly language programs. Again I'm trying to add this file to cross check my output. Again change the file of type to asm and choose stack, add and close. Now build the option. So I don't have errors and warnings in this program. Now I'll debug this program just by clicking this D option as debug. So from where stack memory starts? 08. I'll hit this address directly. But what is this default values? Zeros. But once you execute this program by pressing F11, first I received R0 value with 45 and R1 value with 78. So these two values where I am expecting 08 and 09. So now I received 45 into 08 and 78 into 09. Same R0 and R1 values. So this is how you can cross check your outputs with this Keil Microvision as assembly language programs. Even if you want to test your third program, copy the values of value from ROM location 600H into RAM location 60H. So just see the simple logic. So you cannot write the values into ROM memory through instruction. So you need to use this standard combination as assembly language directives, ORJ and DB. So ORJ and DB allows to save the values into ROM memory. So just define your address followed by ORJ directive and define byte, which allows to save 1 byte value into this ROM location. But how to access this ROM location? Through this DPTR as pointer. So first assign your address as constant value, then move C, which means code memory. So from accumulator from A plus DPTR, which means the indirect address of your DPTR, which is 600H, from 600H location to accumulator. And this accumulator value, you can copy it into 60H RAM location. You cannot transfer your data from ROM memory location to RAM memory without using accumulator. So I'll show you this output with Keil Microvision IDE. So just go file tab and take the new, close this previous program and remove it. So the same program I'm typing here. The value how to keep into ROM memory using this ORJ and DB combination. So now your value is saved in this 600H location. So for that, again go file tab and choose the option save ROM to RAM. Extension don't forget, which is .asm. Save and add your file to source group, which is ROM to RAM. Build the program. Now you can enter into debug session. If you want to check the values of ROM memory, use letter D for RAM, and for ROM use letter C. So now I'm cross-checking what value is saved in 600H location. First of all, see the value 56 is already saved. If you execute this program line by line, this value will get it into RAM. So DPTR is assigned with 600 now, and accumulator received 56. So whatever the value of ROM memory is moved to accumulator first, and this value you are trying to save it in RAM. So now I'll cross-check RAM memory. So I receive 56 into RAM. So this is the way to cross-check your outputs with this Keil Microvision IDE. To stop debug session, use the same button. So this is how you can cross-check your outputs with Keil Microvision IDE. So finally, our intention is very clear: to transfer the values, data transfer between registers, between register to RAM, RAM memory to registers, ROM memory to registers, register to RAM memory. So for more videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube, Aerotech Solutions, and give your valuable feedback through comment. Please like and share our videos. And we are giving training on 3 levels: firmware, IoT and device drivers. So for anyone is interested to learn embedded system training, please go with this contact number 9676327118. We will give all the services with online and classroom. So when you are ready to give with application training also for individuals. If you want to reach our office, please come follow this address: Rajamma Towers, Jayanagar, near KPHP Metro Station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. If you have any queries, please write an email ysnanda@heretechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.